At his boys, we had some conversation today morning. You were studying about Uttaravasti all the time in the morning. You attended male Uttaravasti today. Before and after you got some time, any of you people have gone through what is Uttaravasti, why are we doing? If you are, let us not go into too much detail on Samhita, that and all you get in your colleges, okay? We believe each one doctor here to be a clinician, sit in your own clinic with a minimal setup. You have only, yesterday as if sir said, you have minimal staff and minimal equipment. What will you do with your equipment, and you assume yourself a doctor? How do you make a kalpana of that particular chikitsa? That's what we expect, no? After kaushalam, chikitsa kaushalam. You do a kushalatva in what? You attain kushalatva, knowledge of all the practitioners here, right? We also learned in this way manner. In this manner, like not the mashi exactly what you do here, we have done like that, not that one. Samhita knowledge, what elders have done and what prescriptions they have given, what case sheets they are writing. Just make an observation, but cook up yourself after going home or conversation with different states of people here. We all say like Acharya Padam Adatte. Padam Tishyaha Swamedhaya. Padam Swa Brahmacharibhyaha. Padam Kala Kramenata. So, the second two steps, like Acharya Padam Adatte is the 1/4 Pada of your studies is taken from the books and your teachers, is being done continuously in your campus. And Padam Tishyaha Swamedhaya. You can make your own innovative thinking, not beyond the box. I cannot say out of the box thinking in Ayurveda, because that Ayurvedic box is very big and one end we can find and nobody is able to find the other end of the box of Ayurveda anywhere. So, I cannot say out of the box thinking in Ayurveda anytime, but that box is very precious and you can get whatever you want and what is needed for the life to uplift yourself and for your patients also. So, make that thinking. Cook up your own ideas regarding the treatment principles here. What can you do in your clinic? Make your own ideas. You can share with us also. We are open to that. We never find like senior, junior, nothing is there. They are all gonna be same family Ayurvedic doctors, right? And next, Padam Swa Brahmacharibhyaha. Brahmachari is not the technical Brahmachari of Sanskrit time I am speaking about. You are all the students, like. You are supposed to be the brahmachari of one other self. You converse or you discuss what happened today, what the topics we have learned, what is the clinical side of it, what's the applicable part of it. Do you find any mistakes out of it? You are open to that, no? Do you find any mistakes out of it and what can be the rectification of that? Let's all discuss. Be interactive, be active first, okay? Sabhaya Namaha, Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, with all Sadashiva Samarambham, Vyasa Shankara Madhyamam, Asmad Acharya Pariyantam, Vande Guru Paramparam. With all due respect to my parents, my gurus, see, we still live on Ayurveda. What we eat is through Ayurveda. What we live is through Ayurveda. So, it is the only gonna be lifeline for us in future and even present. Today, my presentation about clinical study on effect of Uttaravasti in regulation of HPV axis. I have been preparing for carcinoma cervix, but some other day. Because yesterday that was a bombarding of carcinoma for you people. I thought like a procedure which we have done today morning itself. So, clinical aspect of that, why actually Uttaravasti is done, what is the action of it in a female patient, is it necessary for all the patients or Uttaravasti alone will be enough for all gynec complaints. My favorite line, so we cannot leave it as such. Ayurveda, the science of life. We have to say it. It is a mandatory line for all seminars, and we have to follow the the three types where the calculative parameters for physical, psychological, social, and spiritual health. The actual definition of health is actually maintained in Ayurvedic parameters only. Physical health cannot be corrected only through pills, and psychological health cannot be corrected alone with counseling, and other social issues cannot be corrected without the help of Swasthavritta measures. And the spiritual health, where we study Tarka Vijnana, Tadvijya Sambhasha, every kind of Charaka Vimana 8th chapter, what it proposes, your upliftment as such spiritually and giving the same positive vibe to the patient, all the four parameters which can be calculatively given from the doctor to the patient is said only in Ayurveda. So nation largely depends on health of women. It's not my word, but it's a true, it's a practical thing. Because the process of procreation of the universe is carried forward by the woman. The healthy procreation is attained through healthy menstruation, thereby healthy conception. We are all, till one part of age, we are all dependent on mother, right? For life, for survival, our food and everything. After that, we are not depending on anybody. We are depending, right? We take a psychological dependence from our sisters, friends, and after that, half of your life is your partner, life partner, a lady. And beyond that, you take love and beyond that affection from your daughter. So everywhere, you take a lady or a girl or a woman takes a chief role to keep you healthy every time. That is only because of her ability to procreate and to manage a family through healthy lifestyle. Thereafter, a technical term like healthy menstruation, and thereby it causes healthy conception. Today in this study for Uttarvasthi, our aims and objectives, I have done a clinical study for 30 patients, and just we are discussing on the statistical values. Only clinically what have been done. I am not going deep into what Uttarvasthi according to Charaka, what is Uttarvasthi according to Ashtanga Hridaya. I am not going into that. Because you people are in academic life now, and you people can better chant the slokas and tell me in between lines what's happening with that. Okay. To evaluate the efficacy of intra-cervical administration of Taila. I have written it intra-cervical, it is Garbhashayagata Uttaravasti. Abnormal HPO axis. We find every gynecological disturbance like PCOS or oligomenorrhea, amenorrhea, any menstrual disturbances with HMB, like heavy menstrual bleeding, abnormal uterine bleeding. Every clinical gynecological condition is happened, manifests only through disturbed hypothalamo-pituitary ovarian axis. If there is no disturbance in your pituitary gland, I am very sure that your ovarian axis is not disturbed. Okay. And to establish the management of HPO axis abnormalities through Ayurvedic perspective, that is Uttaravasti. See, my case is hypomenorrhea. It's working in every case. I may tell you in infertility or oligomenorrhea, as I said, all the clinical entities, what I have said earlier, Uttaravasti can be given in all those cases, provided with the following indications, what I will say in later slides. Hypomenorrhea I have taken. It's also known as short and scanty period, is extremely light menstrual blood flow. Uterine bleeding is slight or less. Which is slight? Which is less? Is there any parameter for that? So yes, there is a parameter. Who bleeds for less than 2 days in their whole menstrual period and is termed as hypomenorrhea. And pituitary dysfunction is the main reason for that, which causes the unresponsive follicle stimulation, which causes ovaries to not get ripened and it becomes unresponsive. See, for understanding all this, you study a bit of menstrual cycle. Which is the primary hormone? In which phase of menstrual cycle, which hormone is active? What action it does? That's all. You can understand the abnormality. It unresponsive ovaries will cause hypomenorrhea. It causes clinical manifestation as undue prolongation of proliferative phase. Proliferation of endometrium is there, one phase, premenstrual phase in menstrual cycle. Only that is prolonged and there is no luteinization hormone sludge, there is no action of progesterone. So it causes with prolonged proliferative phase. Even though the secretory phase is estrogen, even though is normal, the other hormones become unresponsive due to that cut chain of pituitary ovarian axis. So criteria for diagnosis, for many other clinical symptoms, they will say it is scanty. But some people may think like this is scanty even if bleeds for 8 days. Some people thinks it is a heavy menstrual bleed even after 2 days of bleed. So that depends is the sensitiveness of the woman. But there is a clinical parameter given by the WHO. Menstrual bleeding occurring more than 35 days apart remains at same frequency for more than 6 cycles. Unduly scanty, which doesn't even comes for half pad a day. And menstrual flow lasting for less than 2 days. So total 30 patients were taken in our hospital. So intrauterine administration of Hinguadi Taila, that is a composition, Hingu, Kasisa, Sindhuta, Trikshara, Panchalavana, and Samudra Fena is taken, Kumari Sara is taken, Sarshapa Taila is the Taila Dravya, and Drava Dravya is Jala. That is the composition. I may give you the composition also. Hinguadi Taila, reference Baishaja Ratnavali. Arthavikara, Yonavyapat Prakarana, that is given 3 to 5 ml for 5 days following the menstrual phase, that is day 5th to day 10th of the menstrual cycle of the woman for 3 cycles. So the study was Kshina Arthava Dushti will have 3 clinical parameters, Edhochita Kala Adarshanam. As I said you, it will be more than 35 days apart. Uchita Kala is 30 days. Assumed, is a masena upatitam kale. It should be in 30 days. If it goes, edhochita kala adarshanam, uchita kala adarshanam, it's not presented in 30 days, that is beyond 35 days. Alpartavam, that is less than 2 days, and yoni vedana, pain in lower abdomen is observed. These patients were included. These patients with a kshinartava dushti with these 3 conditions are taken for study. See, these patients were 18 to 45. Why only 18 to 45 we have taken for Uttarvasti is, below 18 is legally not allowed. If she is more than 18 years, unmarried patients were not taken for Uttarvasti because of the legal conditions. And beyond 45, they are subjected to premenopausal conditions where this oligomenorrhea is very natural for them and it is healthy for them. It's not abnormal for them to treat something. Just give them advice to food and lifestyle advisors. And next, married woman as a medico-legal aspect. And menstrual flow unduly scanty with anovulation due to oral contraception. People who have taken oral contraception earlier and the diagnosed PCOS in other hospitals. Excluded patients were like lactating mothers. Lactating mothers, we excluded them because unduly scanty is very normal in lactating mothers. And secondary amenorrhea in obesity. See, the cause, yesterday we discussed like rasa nimittam eva karsham stavlyam va. Stavlya samprapti is something different. So, rooting the tree in the roots is a wise idea. So, vasti given in a stavlya should be another composition. Uttaravasti is not directly indicated into that. So this Hinguadi Taila Nasya Vasti, Uttaravasti is not given in secondary amenorrhea due to obesity alone. Just I am quoting this from Ashtanga Hridaya. उत्तरमस्ति संज्ञा उत्तर मार्ग दीयमानतया किंवा श्रेष्ठ गुणतया सी टू वेज वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड द नेम उत्तरेण मार्गेण दीयते बिकॉज वस्ति इज गिवन थ्रू एनल रीजन राइट उत्तर टू दट इज वस्ति रीजन दट इज वेजेनल रूट उत्तरेण मार्गेण दीयमानतया दट विच इज गिवन ऑपोजिट टू द कुद मार्ग इज द उत्तरवस्ति आई विल से उत्तरवस्ति इज द उत्तम बस्ति That is Shrestha. So that it is said, after all the Panchakarmas, he has given a Uttama place to that Vasti. So Uttara Vasti as the Uttama Vasti, he said Shrestha Gunataya Uttara Vasti. The therapy by which the medicine is inserted, we should not generally say inserted. Today morning we were doing all the examination, what should be done, how the cannula at least should be inserted slowly inside, what is the point to be stopped and everything practically we have seen. And if possible, I'll get some video of Uttaravasti for female candidates also. Vagina is termed, urethra or vagina is termed as Uttaravasti. The term Uttaravasti means anterior forward. It's anatomical anterior to Gudamarga. As I said earlier in the shloka, it's the meaning just we have given. It can be given with kashayam. Is there any controversy that Uttaravasti should be given only with Sneha Dravya? Any doctor can say me like it should not be given with Kashaya. But unfortunately, many gynecologists do not administer Kashaya. Very few will administer. But many gynecologists, I have not seen much gynecologists administering Kashaya as the Uttaravasti. They give only Sneha Dravya. So what is the time to be given? Is Artava Kale to Pratikarma Tadarchade? Artava Kala means? During menstruation we are not giving Uttaravasti, right? But here we have seen Srinam Artava Kale to, but you have to see no Aprasravati Mutrecha Bindum Bindrum Shravartapi. Here Aprasravati he said. Where the bleeding has stopped, even in Artava Kala, after 4 days, when the menstruation is stopped, that is the Vyakhyana given by the Acharya. Bindum Bindum Travastati Vidadhyat Uttaravastim. Here, two types of explanation he has given. Bindum Bindum Travastati, he is giving the explanation of Mutra. In Mutra incontinence also, Vasti is given. And Aprasravati, he explained as that when he stops the menstruation. When the lady stops the menstruation, ceases with his menstrual flow, then she should be given with Pratikarma, that is Uttaravasti. Garbhasana, Sukham, Sneham, Tadadate, hi Apavrata, Garbham, Yoni, Tada, Shigram, Dite, Grinnati, Marute, Basti, Jeshu, Vikareshu, Yoni, Vibhramsha, Jeshta. These are all indications. As I said you before, I won't give you good number of indications for that. Only explanation. Balanam to Apatya Marge. You should first learn what to do and very first you learn what not to do. Okay, today in a medical legal aspect, we don't do pervaginal examination for any minor girls or unmarried one. So, what is the condition where Acharya given in even Bala also? Those days it was not the rule, but the Yoni Vibhramsha, if happens, he gives in not Apatya Marga, just intravaginal application of Vasti, he has given as Balanam to Apatya Marga na Diyateva. It's not into vaginal, meatus, into the introitus, intrauterine administration is not done. Intravaginal administration is done in Balanam. Position is very important. Uttanayaha Shayanayaha means she is sleeping. But half of the body is in lifting upside. Uttanayaha, Shayanayaha. Samyak Sankochya Shaktini. Shaktini is your flexed knee. Sankochya Shaktini. This is the position. The position itself is addressed for half of Vatanulomana. Then, Adha Asyaha Pranayet Netram Anuvamshagatam Sukham. Administration of Uttaravasti is explained to the girls today morning. You got all the points? Anyone can tell me 4 or 5 steps of that what we have done in the morning? Anyone? Whatever language you are comfortable, what we have seen, how we have administered Uttaravasti. Thank you, Dr. Bhuvaneshwari. You all understood what she said? I am asking boys. You all understood? See, in lithotomy position, we'll make a patient to make a good imagination. We all make a patient to lie down in a lithotomy position with her flexed thighs, and introitus is examined. Okay, with the proper consent to the patient. It should be a written consent form from every female patient. It's very essential in a medico-legal aspect. Okay, examine the patient for external genitalia. First, any examination will have three parts, right? Darshana, Parshana, Prashna. Prashna Pariksha you are taking through history examination. Darshana examination you have to do in the pubic hair distribution in a female. Said right? Pubic hair distribution is very important in medico-legal cases, and also to understand the hormonal factors of that particular lady. It's a triangular distribution in women and diamond-shaped distribution in men. So, the patient of Kallmann's or Klinefelter kind of a gross hormonal disturbances will have abnormal pubic hair distribution. So, you have to, if a patient comes with infertility to you, and the external genitalia itself reveals so many factors, it's easy for you to treat, right? It makes a point for your diagnosis. Also, you have to check for any abnormal growth near external genitalia. Introitus is to be tested for the skin lesions, any abnormal pus or abscess formations, and visual abnormalities. What is the shape of labia should be? Labia is healthy or not? External genitalia should be tested for that, and internally labia minora should be tested for what? Any glandular accumulations. Many abscess and Bartholin secretions are secreted in minora region. So minora is separated and examined for that. and the patient is asked to take a deep breath or give a cuff or some kind of downward pressure, so that we can know any organ dissent is there or any incontinence is there. We'll ask the patient to void urine before PV examination, right? All the ethics of pervaginal examinations are given very good in book. There are only two clinical conditions we don't accept the patient to void urine before clinical examination, PV examination, is anterior vaginal wall dissent. We wanted to observe the bladder power of the patient, so we say the patient not to void the bladder. Even if we do PV, we say the patient not to void the urine. Okay. With all prerequisites, external genitalia is examined, and internally you have to test a digital examination first. PV should be assessed for uterine size, whether any abnormality structurally inside there, or if the cervix is bleeding on touch. What if it bleeds on touch? If the cervix bleeds on touch, it could be cancer. It's not necessarily cancer every time. It could be some injury when you are inserting speculum also. You should have to differentiate to taking history. See, in cervical carcinoma, patient will typically say a dyspareunia complaint. Okay. Patient will say it's very painful, and post-coital bleeding is a typical symptom of cervical carcinoma. And nowadays, even carcinomas with no bleeding are also seen, just with CIN 1 and 2 stages. So, don't just get misguided with carcinoma. And we have to test for all grave diseases, and internally we are examining the patient now, and we are inserting a speculum to visualize the cervix first. Keep the speculum in a downward and forward manner, and just open the blades of the speculum. Make a self-fixing one for the convenience of a doctor, but not for the patient. Inserting cuspospeculum is very painful for the female patient. You should be very, very capable and doing it with very ease. Make the patient counsel and easy to cooperate with you. Okay. After inserting the cannula into the mouth of the cervix, only the mouth of the cervix is visualized. You cannot see the whole cervix. Only external part of the cervix is visualized. We are inserting the cannula. We are doing for our own ease, like with IUI cannulas we are using. We are inserting the cannula inside through the first step of the cannula. Only around 1.5 inch of the cannula is inserted inside. And we may ask for every step to the patient. We need to speak to the patient, like whether she is feeling that she has any hurt. If she feels any hurt, it's not that we have to take out the cannula. You should observe first whether your position of speculum is correct or not. Two blades of speculum will anyway screw up some way when we are making itself retained. So we have to check whether the position is correct or not. Insert the IUI cannula inside, and you can inject the proposed dravya as I taken Hingwadi Taila. We have today morning we have taken Bala Ashwagandhadi Taila. There are many indications. Selection of drug is your choice according to the Amshamsha Kalpana of the Roga and also the Dravya. Okay. So these were the practical results. So now the main part comes, like how the action, like how the Uttaravasthi will actually take part in hypothalamo pituitary ovarian axis correction. Through the Dravya, first I am explaining. The drugs used in Hingwadi Taila have anti-spasmodic action, anti-inflammatory, carminative, I would say you vatanulomana and also vatahara dravya. All are vatahara, but kshina arthavadushti is the pitta pradana yoni vyapar. Pitta pradana arthavadushti. Why we use all carminative like vatanulomana dravyas here? Any idea? Kshinam tatra pitta vata abhyam, right? Kshinartava dushti is through pitta vata, mainly pitta. But we use all agni samana ushna dravyas here. We use samudra fena, hingu, chitraka, karpura. In that particular taila preparation, we use kumari sara, samudra fena. Nahi vata drute yonir narinam sampradushyati. Without Vata involvement, there is no Yoni Dushti at all. Shamayitva tam anyasya kuriya doshasya veshajam. Only after Vata Shamana, you are supposed to do any other dosha addressing. So here we are doing both together. Like Pitta Vata Shamana together with guna of the that particular dravya. That dravabhuta of Pitta have been increased and Ushna guna is been extremely gone, and that's making Artava Achushana. The samprapti of Kshinartava Dushti is because of the dravaguna of that particular Artava has been taken out by the Pitta in the presence of Vata Vriddhi. That is what happening in Kshinartava. So to combat the samprapti of that, samprapti vigatana is done through giving a taila to give the dravabhaga back again and to correct the Vata Rukshatva with this Vatahara Dravya. Got it? The antioxidant property of these drugs like Hingu, Kshaaratraya, Kumari, Sara is time tested. You have got so many journals on this, which causes the maintenance of estrogen. This is a very wonder to even to us also. Because it's not a Hingwadi Taila is a market, or it's not a market oriented drug, it's not marketed somewhere, it's not available online. We have tested by taking from Samhitas, but astonishingly it maintains the estrogen production, ovulation and proper maintenance of luteal phase and progesterone regulating action on HPO axis is typically observed in this Hingwadi Taila, even given as Pana. The Kasisa and Hingwadi Taila till have hematogenic property, thus its Ratavirdhi property will cause correcting to hypomenorrhea and any other hemoglobinopathies which causing hypomenorrhea in that patient. So antioxidant properties of Haridra, Daru Haridra have anabolic action. So Haridra and Daru Haridra both are Tikta Pachana Dravyas which are Vatahara. At same time Pitta Achushana is controlled through Haridra and Daru Haridra. So now the action of actual Uttaravasti. So theoretically, as per the text, the procedure Uttaravasti is administered and intended to act on Garbhashaya directly. So it is a sthanika chikitsa, it's a part of sthanika chikitsa. You are not correcting the Garbhashaya gata dosha through intake of the drug, get it digested, go through circulation, nothing like that. Then and there it is corrected in Garbhashaya itself. So the virya of the drug administered to reach the Garbhashaya directly, there are three possibilities which are scientifically proven. Direct passive diffusion through the local tissues of cervix. Cervix is very, very sensitive to any particle that is given inside. So even HSD dye is given intracervical, right? So direct passive diffusion, it accepts the liquid when and where is given immediately. And then through cervical lumen, absorption is done. Maximum part is done through diffusion only. The leftover part is taken by the cervical lumen. Then through venous and lymphatic circulation, 1/8 of the part is absorbed through lymphatic circulation. And the 100% active principle is diffused through vascular exchange and through the veins and arteries of that particular region. Most of the capillary branches of the veins and arteries of internal iliac artery and branches of aorta. Then venous drainage of uterus is through, it's a nervogenic action, neurogenic action through first pass effect. When you insert a pichu or give a oil inside the cervix, there is an effect called first pass effect. Even if you pass water, simple water you pass, there is an effect called first pass effect. This is the venous drainage of uterus into iliac vein. So thereby it stimulates the nerve to activate till the pituitary gland. Okay. So conclusion, according to Ayurveda, in Kshinartava Dushti, the line of management is administration of Agneya Dravya. Tatra Agneya Dravyanam Prayogaha Uttamaha, which are Artava Vridhikara, and in the form of Taila, which is very, very useful in Vata Vikara or any Artava Dushti. As a Sthanika Chikitsa also, it has got as a Karma Uttaravasti have got its own efficacy, and also as a Vatahara Dravya Pradhana, it has got a lot of clinical importance. Sthanika Chikitsa is more efficacious in Sri Roga as we observed, and 50% were very good results, and 17 of them have conceived after Uttaravasti. 27% are excellent, like 27% have normal period till now, and 23% are on average. Like, they are not turned up with a good result, but that is also there. Thank you. Any questions from your side? Yeah, we have some other presentation actually, but today morning we have seen the Uttaravasti. I am discussing the clinical part of it. If you have any questions, you may please ask me.
So many faculties are there from finance, management, colleges. So you are doing Uttaravasti in your hospitals. How are you doing?
Uttaravasti, you people are not involved in clinical classes. You are mixing Uttaravasti sometimes, right?
So the general concept is explained that Yoga Uttaravasti, Kala Uttaravasti, Karma Uttaravasti. So when do we Uttaravasti? People are not asking. Either has to be morning, either has to be evening, either has to be before food, either has to be after food. See, the practical entity is entirely different. You are listening to class, you are coming and you are going. But it has to understand the
I am very thankful to my friend. I have done PG with Dr. Satya Prashant. He has raised a possible question actually. See, we go in we'll overgo with slides, but there is a point in between. That is actually indicated. In Vataja Rogi, we give Uttaravasti in the evening. Indications and contraindication timings for Vasti are one and same. But according to the Yukti of the doctor, we have to see the dosha pradhanya. In Uttaravasti, Pura Karma is what? Tam Samshodhya. Without proper Samshodhana, we will not do Uttaravasti. So, now practically all the gynecologists are doing morning they will give Vasti and evening they will give Uttaravasti. Kashaya Vasti if they give in the morning, evening they will give Sneha Uttaravasti. If they give Sneha Matra Vasti in the morning, they will take one Yamakala, like 3 hours time they will take, and next to that they will go with Uttaravasti. If it is Pittaja Pradhana Vyadi, we will do it in the early hours in the morning. In Kapha Kala, mostly nobody does Uttaravasti. That is the explanation.
Thank you, madam. Uddi Pashade Bhava Bhaktana Yojana. So, everywhere you have to use our people logic with help of Vidosha Siddhanta. So, try to discuss and do. So, you people are coming morning and you are doing something, and finally you are not getting final conclusion of the concept. Today, many people are Chodha Bhita Sveta. I asked them, what is the best use in Chodha Bhita Sveta? Nobody said to me. You are doing Uttaravasti. What you are mixing, what you are doing, what is the concept behind it, what is the metaphysical aspect of that Vasti? Let us also discuss. We have our Anthony Modi sir also. So expect more interconnectedness of Ayurveda with you. So try to understand each and every principle, why you are mixing, find out why you are mixing honey. Everything you have to ask and learn, because the concept is very big. Ayurveda is very vast, so we can't discuss each and everything. Madam did very well presentation, but you people have to know minimum basics. When to give Uttaravasti, at what time you have to do that, minimum basics you have to learn. So try to, if you have doubt, you can ask, no problem. Okay? Thank you.
So, like we have a volunteer here who is helping us running this workshop. She has listened to your entire presentation so intently and she has some doubts.
Okay.
Because the other students are not asking, she is asking.
I want to ask that nowadays women are having that problem that endometrial thickness and thinness. If the endometrial is very thick, then they are getting the overbreeding and it is very thick, then it is unable to carry the embryo and become unfertile, embryo, abortions, and all. And I want to know that how this Uttaravasti is useful in practice, and also that the eggs are getting.
Low Definitely. Thank you for a good question. Very burning and alarming issues nowadays. Gynec issues, gynec OPD is full with this endometrial hyperplasia. And see, we have discussed only one disease like hypomenorrhea with that particular hingvalvatyla. But garbhashayagata uttaravasthi have its own action in correcting every hormonal imbalance, I can say you. Endometrial hyperplasia can be regulated, and even the thin endometrium can be regenerated through the efficacy of the drug and also through the efficacious uttaravasthi given. Uttaravasthi is indicated in all types of gynecological disorders. Without any hindrance, we can say that. There is a cure. Yeah, definitely. It happens only due to hormonal imbalance, right? As I said before, HPO axis, if get disturbed, it may cause all these problems. So that ultimately, if that is corrected through the uttaravasthi, here I have seen in last slide we have discussed that HPO axis is corrected through the first pass effect, which is very, very promising, which corrects the GnRH regulation from the pituitary itself. So thereby your thyroid stimulation, TSH stimulation is corrected, where your liver hormones corrected and ACTH is corrected, adrenaline is corrected. It's a chain. So that's why we explain the patients to be in day 5 to day 10 where their active hormones are present and which are manipulated in that correct way. In Ayurveda says Rutu Vyatita Kala. Rutu Vyatita Kala means the cervix is open to accept the maximum efficacy of the medicine. So Rutu Vyatita Kala is the golden period to correct all those endometrial thicknesses. After taking the medicine you are asking. Yeah. That is definitely there. Vasti, any vasti we will give, there is definitely will be a pratyagamana kala, but that differs from person to person. It is as good as vasti. 48 minutes is the maximum time, but no patient will retain it inside, because after it comes out, no lady will know it have come out or not. Generally, we do yoni prakshalana as a purva karma. That is, prior to the procedure, we will do yoni prakshalana, douche kind of procedure to get the cervical muscles loosened and also clean the blemishes of the local infections are to be cleared. And we are very sure that cervical infections which are externally present are not ascended inside through the insertion of our cannula or any other insertion of fingers. Or we make sure that these infections are cleared first and the muscles are loosened through the yoni prakshalana. And the oil which have been given inside is considered yoni purana. It have to fill up until the garbhashaya. So once the work is done, it comes out but collected into the pichu, which have been kept as a paschat karma, post after the procedure. So this pichu will be in contact with cervix for more than 3 hours. And the actual term is the patient should retain it until she get the urge of next urination. That depends on patient to patient, but as such, we take 3 cycles maximum to correct it. So maximum moment. If it is a grave illness, then it may take more time. Thank you for patient listening. Kashayavasthi is also not given in Kapakala because the procedure itself is indicated in the evening. Even if you give Kashayavasthi, you give in Vatahara Kala. See, generally in Uttaravasthi, we are using any Kashaya can be used, but without Ballataka, many gynecologists are taken care of because internal irritation or if Shodhana is not done, we are not sure that Ballataka may not be given inside. But Varanadi, Kashaya, Uttaravasthi is administered in fibroid cases is very, very promising nowadays. And Kashayas like Sukumaram Kashaya and Rasna Erendadi Kashaya. Kashaya is of your own choice. Like you decide the Amshamsha Kalpana of that particular disease. In cervical erosion cases, we have seen in the morning. We give Panchavalkala Kashaya as a Varti we prepare, and even for Purana, Yoni Purana, Garbhashayagata Uttaravasthi, we give Panchavalkala Kashaya. Trifala will make wonder. You make use of proper combination. Trifala can be used in any cases, but you should make a proper combination. That's
it. The Kashaya Uttaravasthi, what is the quantity? Should we combine the oil Uttaravasthi or only Kashaya
Uttaravasthi? Yeah. For Kashaya Uttaravasthi, actually textually they have given Pala or Ardha Pala. But today we cannot push much into that. But there are Vata Prakriti people who can accept 25 ml of kashaya inside. With syringe, 10 ml syringe and bigger syringes and with catheter, we induce until 25 ml I have seen. But minimal to minimal 5 ml they start with on the first day. Because the patient should not have any discomfort. If the patient is comforted, we can ascend to that till 25 ml. Thaila will be given only up to 12 ml. 12 ml maximum. 12 ml is the maximum if the lady can take. She may feel that spill of the fallopian tubes and she feel the pelvic discomfort. That and all there, but 5 to 10 ml is more than enough to induce. You can give vastis in between, but lekhana vasti prayoga is done first and later we will give varanadi kashaya uttaravasti. Lekhana vasti, vasti is given first as a purva karma, then we will give uttaravasti with this kashaya, varanadi kashaya. Some people, they have responded with first cycle itself. Lekhana Vasti itself have treated so many patients and there are patients who take three cycles. We promise with three cycles because three consecutive cycles with normal HPV action will regularize all menstrual abnormalities according to the science. But there are people who take for 6 months, 7 months and that can get cured according to their patya, lifestyle, their stress levels. Because these are all the causative factors where the Nidana Parivardhana is very difficult for them and the Roga also is very difficult for them. Thank you for patient listening. All endo practitioners are here. With all due respects to them, I just presented my cases. Thank you.